स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्तां वो मधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नखाः. बिफोर् वि स्टार्ट् दि उद्योतम् एस् सच् ऐल् जस्ट् गिव् यू वाट् आर् देर् इट्स् अ वेरि स्माल् उद्योतम् ऐल् गिव् यू वाट् इस् देर् इन् फोर्त् उद्योत हि स्टार्ट्स् आफ् वित् कविप्रतिभायाः आनन्त्यम् and in that topic he deals with Anand Vardhana deals with how words of the kavi can attain a new form even if you use the same idea from earlier kavis earlier poets it still can be presented in a more beautiful form if there are other types of dhvani also included in it even if it is the same dhvani that he uses if it is the dhvani shlokam of a purva kavi the idea can be taken and presented in such a manner that it can actually be much better than the earlier kavi also because of pratibha anantyam the ideas and creativity that keeps coming about say if it was only kalidasa who was the greatest poet we would not have a bharavi or a magha or naishadhakara shriharsha many other poets who even today are writing shlokas every day as we speak so that is if the things have not been exhausted it's because things has not been exhausted right so things creativity is something that keeps on improving if you see the more and more modern people thinkers they are influenced by so many things in the world and they that influence is also shown in their writings it is the same with art it's a living thing any form of art whether it is literature or music or dance you find newer things to come up with in the 9th century Anandavardhana was able to point out and he was so accepting of newer forms I you know there was a small if you get time you should listen to this conversation between I think Shri Balamurli Krishna and Prince Rama Varma so there they both he talks about what is tradition you know we talk about tradition so much that we forget that innovation is also part of a tradition as you follow that tradition you are within a set of sphere but still you can be more creative even within that limits that so called limits that is kavi navinatvam vaani navinatvam is what the creativity that you each person has because of the experience they go through every person is different so kavi navinatvam kavi vaanyaha navinatvam and in every dhvani pravedam you can find that apurvatvam in the words or artha apurvatvam there can be vyanjaka bhedena apurvatvam deshakala bhedena apurvatvam so many different contributions so many different ideas can contribute to a new expression that a kavi can make the next topic he deals with is the pradhana rasam in ramayana and mahabharata And then he goes on to a little bit of auchityam and based on deshakalam how the expression can differ what was accepted probably in the 9th century or what was normal in 9th century may not be the same today in the 21st century right so it depends so because of that the words and the world of literature is also endless the last topic he deals with is samvadaha very commonly a lot of people will say it is plagiarism but it is not it is you are influenced by the idea of another person and you try to make it yours there can be different ways in which you show that influence in your own writing so this entire section starts off as a prayojanam for the earlier three sections we have not read the third till now it is there for the second year in the third udyotam he only deals with vyanjaka bhedam and there are so many different topics that it is equal to 1 2 and 4 put together it's such a vast udyotam at the end of that he says we have learnt about all of these to understand what an uttama kavyam is or to write an uttama kavyam on our own satkavyam kartum athava gnyatum there is a Karika at the end of third Udyotam, the 45th Karika, he says, Ityuktalakshanaha yaha dvanihi vivechyaha prayatnataha sadbihi. We have to analyze this dvani along with its divisions. Yat prayatnataha, with a great effort, we have to analyze what is going on in this dvani and dvani pravedaha. For what? Satkavyam kartumva jnatumva samyak abhyuktaihi. One who is extremely involved in this can understand how to write a kavyam, and he can also understand to recognize which is a good kavyam and which is not. This gives us the tools to understand that. So let's go to the text now. Evam dvanim. Before we start with this, I was looking at the Mangala Shlokam of Lochanam. It's so beautiful that I wanted to just quickly give a small explanation for that. Kritya panchaka nirvaha yoge api parameshwaraha na anya upakarana apekshaha yaya tamnaupi shankari. Till now I did not look up his Lochana's Mangala Shloka. Very beautiful small shlokas he writes. Just this Kritya Panchakam. Kritya Panchakam is, there are five types of work that Parameshwara undertakes in this world, which is Srishti, Sthiti, Layam, Samharam, Tirobhavaha, Anugraham. Tirobhavaha, Anugraham, these are two extra which they talk about. He's a great Shaivite. So his shlokas also tell you about that. So Parameshwaraha, Kritya Panchaka Nirvaha Yoge Api, यया कृत्य पंचक निर्वाग योगे अपि परमेश्वरः सः ताम मायाशक्तिं शंकरीं शंकरस्य मायां न अन्य उपकरण अपेक्षः सः. So Kritya Panchaka Nirvaha Yoga, in the process of Sthiti, Samhara, Laya, Tirobhava and Anugraha, na anya upakarana apekshaha parameshwarah. Shiva does not expect another person's help in any of these things. Why? Yaya. Because he is with her. Because he is with that Maya Shakti, he does not expect another sahakari for himself. Tam Shankarim Naomi. I offer my salutations to that Maya Shakti. This is a very condensed version of the Sandarlari Shlokam. Giram Ahur Devim, Druhina Grihinim, Agamaldo, Hare Patnim Padma Maharasahachari, Madritanayam, Turiya Kapitvam, Duradigaman, Sima Mahima, Mahamaya, Vishwam, Brahmayasi, Parabrahma, Mahishi. You are that Maya, Turiya. You are the fourth aspect. You are beyond Saraswati, Lakshmi and Parvati. You are that fourth aspect which is called the Maya, Maya Shakti. We'll go to Dhvani here. Otherwise, this will become another.
Akka, what is that fourth one? Srishti, Sthiti, Laya, then what? The
Tirobhavaha Anugraha. Tirobhavam is the. He has the, it is not just complete layam, not pralayam, but you know, there is a he is responsible for both tirobhavam means adu eppadi solradhu removal la bhramam. He creates that brahma, which is that tirobhava. This is avarana shakti. Correct ah mudichu. Avarana shakti is where you are you don't understand that this world is Shiva, in fact, or it is that Brahma Swarupam. So the Maya, Shiva is able to conceal everything from us. It's because of that Maya Shakti that he has with him.
Oh. Yeah, very nice, Akka.
Yeah.
No,
the third one, or இதுவும் ரொம்ப ரன்னா இருக்கும்.
ரொம்ப
அழகா இருக்கும். विप्रतिपत्ति निरासार्थं व्युत्पाद्य तद्व्युत्पादने प्रयोजनान्तरं प्रयोजनान्तरं उच्यते. विप्रतिपत्ति निरासार्थं ध्वनिं सप्रपञ्चं व्युत्पाद्य विप्रतिपत्ति स सहृदय मनः प्रीतये तत्स्वरूपं काव्यस्यात्मा ध्वनिरीति बुधैः यः समाम्नातपूर्वः तस्य आभावं जगदुरपरे भक्तमाहुस्तमन्ये. அதுக்கப்புறம் யூ ஷுட் ஹவ் மெமரைஸ்ட் பை நவ் பக்தமாக ஸ்தமன்யே வாசாம் ஸ்திதம் அவிஷயே தத்வமூச்சு ஸ்ததீயம் தேன ப்ரூம சஹிருதய மன பிரீதையே தத்ஸ்வரூபம். ரிமெம்பர் தட் ஸ்லோகம் ஹியர் தட் இஸ் ஹி அல்யூட்ஸ் டு தட் ஹியர் விப்ரதிபத்தி நிராசார்த்தம். தேர் ஆர் மெனி மிஸ்கன்செப்ஷன்ஸ் அபவுட் துவனி. Vyutpadya, nirasartham vyutpadya. In order to remove those misconceptions about dhvani, I have said the I have given the dhvani lakshanam and dhvani swarupam with saprapancham ityukte veda sahitam. Along with its revision, after giving those vyutpadya, tad vyutpadane prayojanantaram uchyate. There is another prayojanam also in for me. It is not only sahirdaya manav pritaye. To remove the misconception and to please the connoisseurs. It is not only for that. There is another prayojanam also for common people to understand what a good kavyam is and what a bad kavyam is, or to just distinguish a great poetry from a very normal poetry. And to understand that. If I want to get into poetry writing also, I should know. First, I should be able to distinguish between what is good and what is bad, or what is good, what is better. We should know that difference also. Very beautifully, he points out that. We've been thinking that Shunyam Vasagriham is a very nice shlokam. I didn't want to point it out at that point of time. So it makes more sense after studying all of this. Dvanehe yaha sa gunibhuta vyangyasya adva pradarshitaha அனேன ஆனந்தியம் ஆயாதி கவீனாம் பிரதிபா குணஹா. பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தட் பிரதிபா குணஹா, பிரதிபா கவீனாம் பிரதிபா குணஹா ஆனந்தியம் ஆயாதி அனேன 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 த்வதி த்வனி பிரபஞ்ச நிரூபணேன. பை கிவிங் த டிவிஷன்ஸ் ஆஃப் த்வனி, பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் த கவீனாம் பிரதிபா குணஹா, த கிரியேட்டிவிட்டி ஆஃப் poets ஆனந்தியம் ஆயாதி, இட் பிகம்ஸ் இன்யூமரபிள் ஆர் இன்ஃபினிட். த பிரதிபா ஆஃப் போயிட்ஸ் பிகம் இன்ஃபினிட் பிகாஸ் த பாத் ஆஃப் துவனி ஹஸ் பீன் ஷோன். துவனேஹே யா அத்வா பிரதர்ஷிதா, கசிய துவனேஹே சகுணி ச குணீபூத வியங்கிய துவனேஹே அத்வா பிரதர்ஷிதா. அலாங் வித் குணீபூத வியங்கிய ஐ ஹவ் ஷோன் த பாத் ஆஃப் துவனி இன் தி சென்ஸ் துவனேஹே லக்ஷணம் பிரபேதாக அண்ட் கதம் வியஞ்சக வியங்கிய முகேன. Also, in fact, third deals with that vyanjakatvam in pada, vakya, prabandha, rasam, everything he will deal with in third udyotam. Third udyotam is very important in understanding the text and dhvani concept, especially how the rasas play a point, a role in it, how the vritti also has a role in it. So dhvanehe ச குணீபூத வியங்கிய துவனேஹே யா அத்வா பிரதர்ஷிதா, யா மார்கா பிரதர்ஷிதா, தேன தேன மார்கேண தேன துவனே துவனி பிரபஞ்சேன கவீனாம் பிரதிபா குணா ஆனந்தியம் ஆயாதி. வி அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தட் த பிரதிபா ஆஃப் போயட்ஸ் இஸ் இன்ஃபினிட் ஆனந்தியம். ய ஏஷா துவனேஹே குணீபூத வியங்கிய ச மார்கா பிரதர்ஷிதா பிரகாஷிதா தஸ்ய பலாந்தரம். வாட் இஸ் தி அதர் பலம் ஃபார் தட்? கவி பிரதிபா ஆனந்தியம். த வே ஹி ரைட்ஸ் த விருத்தி இஸ் ஹி சேஸ் த இன்ஃபினிட் நேச்சர் ஆஃப் கிரியேட்டிவிட்டி இஸ் தி அதர் பிரயோஜனம் ஃபார் துவனி மார்க பிரதர்ஷனம். துவனிமார்க்கம் கிமர்த்தம் பிரதர்ஷியதே இத்யுக்தே கவீனாம் பிரதிபா ஆனந்தியார்த்தம். வாட் இஸ் த ரிலேஷன் ஹியர்? சி துவனி அண்ட் குணிபூத வியங்கிய த டிஃபரெண்ட் டிவிஷன்ஸ் ஆஃப் துவனி எக்ஸெட்ரா ஆர் இன் த காவியம். பிரதிபா தூ கவினிஷ்டம் அஸ்தி, ஹவு கேன் தேர் பி அ கனெக்ஷன் பிட்வீன் த டூ ஆஃப் தெம்? பை நோயிங் தட் தேர் கேன் பி டிஃபரெண்ட் வெரைட்டிஸ் எ போயட்ஸ் creativity is stimulated because of that, and he will try to employ any of those. He need not use all 51 varieties of Shuddha Dvani, Uttama Kavya. He can use even one Prakaram, just with Arthantra Nyasa, Arthantra Sankramitam, he can create a new Kavyam with that, new Shlokam with that, give a new dimension to what is existing already. Katham iti chet, ataha hi anyatamenapi prakarena vibhushita vani navatvam ayati purvartha anvayavati api. Ataha katham iti chet, katham ityukte kavi pratibha anantyam phalantaram katham bhavitum arhati. The lochanam here is, I'm just going to read from the lochanam for all this. Without that, we are never going to understand the avantara sangati. Nanu dvani prabedat pratibhanam anantyam iti. If you see the red line marks, that is where I'm reading from. So nanu dvani bedat pratibhanam anantyam iti vyadhikaranam yetat ityabhiprayena ashankate katham iti chet. Vyadhikaranam. So dvani exists in the kavyam, kavyanishtam. Pratibhatu kavinishtam, how can this be a cause for pratibha anantyam? Iti vyadhikaranam, vyadhikaranam samanadhikaranam nasti tatra. Dvani prabhedanam adhikaranam tu kavyam, pratibhanam adhikaranam tu kavinishta kavi buddhihi. So the adhikaranam is not samanadhikaranyam. How can you connect these two and say this is the prayojanam for this? Katham iti chet, ataha hi अन्यतमेनापि प्रकारेण विभूषिता वाणी पूर्वार्थ अन्वयवत्यपि नवत्वम् आयाति. पूर्वार्थ अन्वयवति, पूर्वार्थ पूर्वेषाम् अर्थ अर्थान् अनुसरति वाणी. सो वाट् एवर् अ न्यू पोएट् हू विशस् टु रैट् अ न्यू पोएट्रि, हि टेक्स् दि ऐडिया फ्रम् अदर्स् अर्लियर् पीपल्. Like Kalidasa, for example, he takes from Padma Puranam the story of Dushyanta and Shakuntala, or he takes it from Mahabharatam. If you look at Bhavabhuti, he takes the idea from Valmiki. If it is Bhattanarayana in Veni Samharam, he takes it from Mahabharatam. So everybody have taken their Katha Vastu, not only Katha Vastu, even one particular shlokam. This is an entire story that you have in hand. You remove what you don't want, you take what you want, you take the essence of the story and portray it in a different manner in an entire kavya. That is okay. But even in one shlokam, you can express a novelty in it. Idea can arise in a very new manner. Purana Vityeva Nasadhu Sarvam Najapi Kavyam Navavityavadhyam Santah Parikshya Anyatarad Bhajante Moodaha Paraprateya Buddhi. This Kalidasa says in Malakagnitra. This is Purana Vityeva Nasadhu Sarvam. Don't dismiss anything new. Purana Vityeva Nasadhu Sarvam. Just because it is tradition, old, it is the greatest thing and it is the best work. Not necessary. Nasadhu Sarvam. Nachapi Kavyam Navamiti Avadhyam. You should not dismiss a new Kavyam because it is new. The very fact that it is new, it should not be dismissed. You know, you can, there can be a different idea. That's why adhaadu tamil la solradha dhaan seri, aanana patta kalidasane indha maadhiri oru slogan sollirche nammalla emmaathra. Kalidasa felt his work was a new work. What to say of the others? So purvartha anvayavati api vaani, even though it follows the idea of another person before, another kavi who has said something before. Vani katham anyatamenapi prakarena vibhushita sati. If that new poet's words are vibhushita, are adorned by even at least one prakaram that I have mentioned so far. In three udyotams, if you look at this, this fourth udyota is not 1/4 of the text. It is very less. 85% of the text is over. So he has shown so many different varieties of dvani and given different examples for dvani. Anyatamena api prakarena ityukte ekena api prakarena tatra. Even with just addition of one type of dvani into that shlokam, and it decorates that shloka, tadrashi vani navatvam ayati. It attains a very லெட்ஸ் சே இட் கெட்ஸ் அ நாவல்டி, நத்திங் எல்ஸ். ஒரு ஒரு அழகு வந்துடுது, புதுசா இருக்கு பாக்குறதுக்கு. இட்ஸ் வெரி ஃப்ரெஷ் வென் யூ லுக் அட் இட். யூ வில் சடன்லி ஃபீல், ஓ நோபடி ஹாஸ் மென்ஷன்ட் இட் லைக் திஸ். அத்வனே உக்த பிரபேத மத்யாத் அன்யதமேனாபி பிரகாரேண விபூஷிதா சதி வாணி. ஐ வாண்ட் டு சே திஸ். சோ வர்ணனீய வஸ்துநிஷ்டா பிரஜா விசேஷா பிரதிபானம் தத்ர வர்ணனீயஸ்ய பாரிமித்யாத் ஆத்ய கவினா ஏவ ஸ்பிருஷ்டத்வாத் சர்வஸ்ய தத் விஷயம் பிரதிபானம் தத் ஜாதீயமேவ ஸ்யாத் ததஸ்ச காவ்யமபி தத் ஜாதீயமேவ இதி ப்ரஷ்டஹ இதானீம் கவிப்ரயோகஹ. வாட் இஸ் த நெசசிட்டி ஃபார் சம்வன் டு ரைட் அ போயிட்ரி? சி வர்ணனீய வஸ்துநிஷ்டஹ, what we are trying to write, the pratibhanam, the creativity of a poet, it is a prajna visheshah, a buddhi visheshah asti. And what does it rely on? Varnaniya vastu nishtah. It depends on the plot that we are trying to describe. Tatra varnaniyasya, that which has to be described, parimityate, it is very limited. In if you look at third udyotam, he will say, you know, divyam adivyam, there are so many, there may be many divisions, but still there are extremely limited conditions that he puts for choosing a plot or choosing a hero, neta. So many different limitations that are there for a poet to write his kavyam. Parimityat ஆத்ய கவினா ஏவ ஸ்பிருஷ்டத்வாத். ஆத்ய கவினா பூர்வ கவினா, ஐதர் பை யூ கேன் சே வால்மீகி ஆர் எனிபடி. ஆத்ய கவி காவ்ய ஜாத்தியம், சோ யூ கேன் சே ஐதர் இட் ஃபாலோஸ் ராமாயணம், எனிதிங் தட் சம்வன் ரைட்ஸ், ஓ வால்மீகி ஹேஸ் ரிட்டன் இட் பிஃபோர். See, it's a very beautiful idea that it will, nobody has written an upama like this. Deepashikeva Kalidas, Deepashika Kalidasaha, he has given such beautiful upama. Valmiki has done it. Akashaiva Nirmalaha, nobody can beat that upama. I feel, you know, for Bharata he says Akashaiva Nirmalaha, the chance of malatvam, malinyam, can never happen in akasham. You cannot say that the sky is dirty. You can say the air is polluted. You can never say that the space is polluted. Bharata is like that. Akasha iva nirmalaha. Nobody can write an upama like that. Upama Kalidasasya is later. But still we give him that title. Why? Because of that navinatvam. Ukta vaichitriyam. So many different types of dhvanis that have been said. He is given a new dimension to it. Yeah, so adya kavina eva sprishtatvat, even Valmiki has touched upon all of those topics. Sarvasya tad vishayam pratibhanam tajjatiyam eva. Tajjatiyam ityukte adya kavi kavya jatiyam eva, it just follows adya kavi. Syat, it's possible that everything seems to be on the, oh, this is what he has also written, this is what he has also written, this is what he has done. When someone sings this sangati GNB has sung, this sangati MTR has sung, but if you keep on thinking about it in that manner, you will never look at the beauty that someone is singing right now, right? So tatascha kavyam api tajjatiyameva pratibha vishesham. The kavya vastu follows adya kavi kavya vastu. In the same manner, the nutana kavyam api tajjatiyameva ityukte adya kavi kavya jatiyameva syat. Then what happens? Brashtaha idanim kaviprayogaha. Any effort that the poet has done, it becomes secondary. Brashtaha means it is not nashtaha, but it becomes very secondary. How do we get that? Then how does that anantyam, how can you justify that anantyam here? Ukta vaichitriyena dvani prabedhanam vaichitriyena. The variety of dvanis that I have said, arthaha niravadhayaha, there is no limit for meaning, artha, or situations and topics that we need. It is a limitless world that we see. Tad vishayanam pratibhanam anantyam upapannam iti. When the dvani vishesham, all the types of dvani has not been explored. Nobody till now has given 51 examples of just the shuddha dvani varieties. There are 51 types of dhvani, right? If you look at Kavya Prakasham, but none of the Alankarika still now has been able to give an example for each and every variety of those 51 types, right? I don't think even Pratap Rudriyakara has done that. So, la.
இல்ல 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 நல்ல வேலை இல்ல.
ஆமா, see, he is not even touched 51, but if you look at Kavya Prakasha or Pratap Rudriyam, he says some 5300 and something something with permutation combination along with Guni Bhutam. Imagine the extent of udaharanam that you have, which is still unexplored. So niravadhayaha, it is just limitless meaning and limitless permutation combination that you can come about. Hence pratibhanam api anantyam, as someone can come about with a combination that has not been said till now. The justification of that pratibha anantyam is beautiful. Ataha, the vritti for the text is ataha dvanehe ukta prabheda madhyat anyadamena api prakarena vibhushita sati vani puratana kavi nibaddha artha samsparshavatyapi. Even if it is if it just touches upon the idea of an old kavi, navatvam ayati, there is a beauty to it, a freshness to it. Tathahi avivakshitavachasya dvanehe. Now he gives you examples of each and every, not all 51, luckily. He just gives us four types, the main four principal types. You have avivakshita vachidvani and vivakshita anyapara vachidvani. Avivakshita vachidvani being lakshanamuladvani, two varieties of that is atyanta tiraskritam and arthantara sankramitam. He gives an example for atyanta tiraskritam and arthantara sankramitam. In the same manner, for vivakshita anyapara vachidvani, it is abhidhamuladvani with two divisions of samlakshikramadvani and asamlakshikramadvani. He gives an example for asamlakshikramadvani, and for samlakshikramadvani, he just mentions a line. He does not give the full example. Let me see how much I can cover today. We'll start with one and maybe I'll continue next class. Tatahi avivakshita vachyasya dvanehe prakara dvaya samashrayena navatvam purvartha anugame api yatha. So purvartha anugame api, even if it is, if it follows the earlier poet's ideas, in avivakshita vachidvani there are two types, prakara dvayam, tiraskritam and arthantara sankramitam. He is going to give an example for both of that. Navatvam katham iti yatha. I'm going to read the first shlokam, not the first shloka, the second shloka first, and then go to the first shlokam. So it is not in this manner in the text. The text actually goes with the better shloka first, and then the shloka, the earlier shloka later. So it'll make more sense to read the second shlokam first and then go to the how it has been expressed in a much more beautiful manner. So let's first appreciate the less beautiful shloka and then go to the more beautiful one. So sa vibrama smita udbedaha lolakshyaha praskaladgiraha nitamba alasa gaminyaha kaminyaha kasyana priyaha. Kaminyaha kasyana priyaha, who what is not endearing about ladies? Ladies, people love people, women, right? Kaminyaha kasyana priyaha sarveshamapi apito sarveshamapi priyaha eva. They are endearing to everybody. How are those ladies? Everything else is visheshanam for kaminyaha. Sa vibrama smita udbhedaha. Sa vibrama vilasa yukta smita udbhedaha. Udbhedam is slightly opening. So as they are smiling, they're not just having a plaster smile on their face. Nobody can, you know, if you're smiling with your heart, you either, it's an open smile, open laughter, or an open smile where at least a little bit of your, you know, the lips won't be tight and like that. It's like drawn lips. There should be a slight opening for you to show what is there in the heart, right? So sa vibrama, there is a beauty associated with that slight smile. Smita udbhedaha kaminyaha tadrishyaha kaminyaha lolakshyaha, their eyes are flashing, like, you know, lolam, it is moving, chanchalatva. Praskalat giraha, their words are, praskalat means it's not falling down, or you know, it's more like there is a flow to their speech. It is slightly trembling and it's flowing very beautifully from their the speech is flowing very beautifully. Tadrishyaha kaminyaha nitamba alasagaminyaha. Alasagaminyaha, their gait is they walk in a very slow manner, or they have a very slow gait because of the weight of their hips. Nitambaihi alasagaminyaha kaminyaha kasyana priyaha. Everybody would love girls or women who are beautiful and graceful, with their smile and eyes are moving, with sweet speech, and they're walking in a very graceful manner. This is nice. Not a great dhvani shlokam. In this, it's not a dhvani shlokam at all. He adds avivakshita vachita atyanta tiraskritatvam, and another kavi who has come later has transformed this shloka very beautifully. Smitam kinchin mugdham tarala madhuro drishti vibhavaha. Reading the first one now. Parispandho vacham abhinava vilasormi sarasaha gatanam arambah kisalayita lila parimalaha sprishantyaha tarunyam kimivahi naramyam mrigadrishaha. Very similar to kimivahi madhuranam mandanam nakritinam. சரி,
இந்த சந்தஸே ரொம்ப அழகா இருக்கு. இந்த இந்த ஐடியாவை சொல்றதுக்கு
எதுமா
இந்த இந்த சந்தஸ், இந்த ஸ்மிதம் கிஞ்சின் அந்த இதுவே ரொம்ப
அழகா இருக்கு. கிமிமஹி ந ரம்யம் மிருகத்ருஷஹா, இந்த அந்த ஐடியாவை போடுறதுக்கு அழகா இருக்கு. மிருகத்ருஷஹா கிம் இவ ந ரம்யம் அபிதோ சர்வமேவ ரம்யம். மிருகத்ருஷா, அ லேடி ஹூஸ் ஐஸ் ஆர் லைக் ஃபீமேல் டியர், தஸ்யாஹ எவ்ரி திங் தட் இஸ் தேர் இன் ஹர், வாட் இஸ் நாட் பியூட்டிஃபுல், வாட் இஸ் நாட் சார்மிங், ஆஸ் ஷி டச்சஸ் தாருண்யம், தாருண்யம் ஸ்பிருஷந்தியாஹ மிருகத்ருஷா கிம் கிம் ந மதுரம் அபிது சர்வமபி மதுரம் ரம்யமேவ. As she is on the threshold of யௌவனம், as she touches யௌவனம், everything else is beautiful. Praptetu shodashe varshe gardhavi pyapsarayate. Even a she donkey looks like a, that is actually ashraya vedena. You can explain it differently. Gardhavi pyapsarayate ityukte any lady would seem like apsara stri, whether she is beautiful or not. It is that yavvanatvam that prompts you to look at everything with beauty. La? Here, tarunyam sprishantyaha mrigadrishaha, as she touches upon youth, how is she? Kinchit mugdham smitam. He describes each and every, just like smita udbedaha, sa vibrama smita udbedaha. Instead of that, here, smitam kinchit mugdham. Mugdham, mugdhatvam is innocent. Huh? Innocent means it's so beautiful. Innocence has a beauty to it. You know, when a child talks something, you look at the innocent nature with which he says or she says, and you appreciate it much more than an adult saying those same words. You don't look at it with the same endearing attitude that you look at with a child. That mugdhatvam is that sort of an innocence that you're looking at. So even if someone is very innocent, even if it is an adult who is very innocent, you look at it with a, that prompts an endearing nature in you. There is a beauty associated with that mugdhatvam. So kinchit mugdham, that smile is a little innocent. There is no she's not chalu. You can know that if it is a smirk or a grin, you know, where she has something in mind and then saying no. That smile is very reflective of the innocence that is there in her. So there is a beauty. Smile is not innocent. So that mugdhatvam here, vachyarthaha is vachyarthaha vadhyate and then vengyartham. You have a lakshyam and then vengyam. Lakshyam is sadrishyam. So just as how a person chetana vastu is mugdaha in the same manner, and there is a beauty to it, the same manner this smile also is guileless. There is no hidden agenda to that. So it is very beautiful. Anahrita saundarya, that is vyangyam here. Tarala maduraha drishti vibhavaha, drishti vibhavaha, drishti drishtyaha vibhavaha aishwaryam tarala maduraha. It is just there is a, the her glances are very sweet and it's trembling. It is not fixed on one point, it is just chanchala there. So taralatvena maduraha drishti vibhaha, maduraha is associated with rasana here, so that maduratvam is baditatvam lakshyartham, we have to go to that. So tiraskrita vachyadvani, every word becomes atyanta tiraskritam and there is a vyangyartham associated with it. So maduraha ityukte, it attracts everybody. Her sight is such that everybody feels sarvajana vallabhya vallabhata. Idhila potirpar in lochanam appa, to read his vyakhyanam is like one reading kadambari gadyam there. In, for this shlokam especially, drishti vibhavaha, the glances, he says the wealth of glances, vibhavaha, how can there be aishwaryam associated with glance? That wealth is she, it is not that today she sees with a beauty, there is a beauty, the maduratvam in her drishti today, tomorrow it is lost, you know, there is akshinatvam, it is continuously present and that is seen in that because of that there is a madhuryam also with her eyesight. So drishti vibhavaha parispando vacham abhinava vilasorme sarasaha, vacham parispandaha, the vaarthigalinudaiya tudippungro, the eppadi solradhu, quiver in her voice, it doesn't explain that for me, that Tamil is so beautiful there, and the vaarthaiyoda oru tudippu iruke. So when you start to talk, you are waiting to talk, you know, that the starting words and how she starts speaking, all of those are abhinava vilasa urme sarasaha. It is so full of rasam. It is rasa yuktam asti abhinava vilasam. It has a new grace to it, a new beauty to it, because it is also urmi, it is like waves of sarasatvam, rasa yuktatvam asti tasyaha vachi. Even though we have heard so many people speak, but the moment they get into that yavanam, their speech is different. You will understand when you see the transformation between a child to a youth. Even a child is so beautiful. Adana kudalinidu yaalinidu enbar தம்மக்கள் மழலிச்சொல் கேளார். பீப்புள் வில் ஃபீல் தட் குழல், யூனோ த ஃப்ளூட் சவுண்ட் இஸ் பியூட்டிஃபுல், த வீணா சவுண்ட் இஸ் பியூட்டிஃபுல் இஃப் தே ஹவ் நாட் ஹர்ட் தேர் சில்ட்ரன்ஸ் சவுண்ட். ஸோ ஃபார் ஈச் பர்சன் தேர் சைல்ட், த எனி திங் தட் ஸ்பீக்ஸ், எனி திங் தே ஸ்பீக் இஸ் சோ பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஃபார் தேம், அண்ட் தில் கீப் ஆன் அப்ரிஷியேட்டிங் இட். யூல் சி மதர்ஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் கோயிங் அண்ட் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் தேர் சில்ட்ரன் டு அனதர் பர்சன். ஸோ தட்ஸ் ஹவ் இட் இஸ் ஹியர். அஃப்கோர்ஸ் it is tharunyam that is playing a role here. And so vacham parispandaha, the words that come out of her mouth, they are abhinava vilasa, it is a new experience, and hence sarasaha rasa yuktam asti. Gatanam arambaha kesalayita leela parimalaha, gatanam arambaha, as she walks, her walk is parimalaha, is perfumed with leela, it is perfumed with a grace which is kisalayitam, which is just coming forth. As she walks, there is a grace in her. See, perfume is not something you douse yourself in. It is just sprinkled, right? So she's just started to learn how to walk with a grace. She's not an experienced person in this. So gatanam arambaha, the beginning of her walk, kisalayitam, it's like buds which are coming forth, it is still not bloomed into a full flower. Tadrisha leela parimalaha asti tasyaha gatya. This again, kisalayitam, how can walking be compared to budding? Kisalayam, it's only that saukumaryam, there is a softness to her walk. that is seen in suggested here. So tarunyam sprishantyaha, sprishantyaha, again you can, she can't touch youth here. So sprishana sparshanasya ayatma siddhatva, it is a natural process, that it is not something she has decided today that okay, I'm a teenager, I'm a youth, I'm going to start behaving like this from tomorrow, day one. It's not like that. It is something that has come naturally to her, ayatna siddham, without an effort. All of these vyangyartham I've just taken from Dhana Lochanakara. I'll just read it once. Mugdha, madhura, everything is yathasankhyam here. Mugdha, madhura, vibhava, sarasa, kisalayita, parimala, sparshana, sparshanani, atyanta tiraskritani. Taihi, from those words, what we get is the vyangyam, anahrita saundarya. Mugdha shabdasya anahrita saundaryam. Madhura shabdasya sarvajana vallabhyam. So sarvajana vallabhya, vibhavasya akshina prasaratvam. Then sarasatvam. Sarasatvam ityukte santapa prashamanam. If prashamana tarpakatva, tarpakatva pleasing. Santapa prashamanena santoshakaratvam, tarpakatvam from kisalayitam. Sorry, sarasam. From kisalayitam we get saukumarya. Sarvakalika tat samskara anuvritti. That is from parimalam. Parimalam means it is a fragrance that is associated with the flower always. So sarvakalika tat samskara anuvrittitvam. She is always with a leela in her. The leela parimalaha. Her walk suddenly has become associated with that fragrance that is making it even more beautiful. If there is a flower which has no smell. Now, my mother who visits from India, she would always say, this country has so many rose bushes, but none of it has fragrance. Whereas even a small flower in India has so much of fragrance. Maybe that's also a personal attachment to India, I guess. But
என்னோட அம்மாவும் இதே தான் சொல்லுவா.
ஒரு பன்னீர் ராஜா மாதிரி வராதம்பா.
That is true.
Yeah, very true. Even with vegetables we find that. Yeah. The vegetables are big, big. But even a small capsicum will have more flavor in India, I feel.
Yeah.
I think it's just a personal this thing, but it's okay. I mean, so parimalam, he says the vyangyartham from parimalatvam is sarvakalika tat samskara anuvrittitvam. It is always associated with that fragrance. So she always has that leela in her walk. Gatana marambha. Abram sparshanam ityasya ayatna abhilashaniya sangatatvam. Ayatna abhilashaniyam. Very easy to like her at this stage. Any man would fall in love with such a person who has just entered into youth. Yeah, gardavi pyapsarayate. That's what it means. Sangatatvani dhanyamanani yani taihi smitadehe prasiddhasya arthasya stavira. Stavira vedho vihita dharma vyatikarena dharmantara patrata yavat kreda. We'll leave lochanam at this. I just wanted to read only that vyangyartham for that, the way he has written it. Okay, now let's go back to the next shlokam. So which is iti prakara dvaya samashrayena navatvam purvanya yatha smitam kinchin mugdam ityasya. That's how the text goes, right? Ityasya sa vibhrama smita udbedaha lolakshyaha praskaradgiraha ityevamadishu shlokeshu satsu api. So even if the second shloka is present, ityevamadishu shlokeshu satsu api tiraskrita vachya dvani samashrayena kasya purva smitam kinchin mugdham iti shlokasya tiraskrita vachya dvani samashrayena, because it has atyanta tiraskrita vachya dvani apurvatvam pratibhasate eva. It is much more beautiful than this one. Huh? Next, he goes to Arthantra Sankramitam. Again, we will read the second shlokam. Svateja Krita Mahima Kenanyena Atishayate Mahadbhirapi Matangaihi Simhaha Kim Abhibhuyate Svatejasa Krita Mahima Simhaha Simhaha, a lion, he has bought his greatness, Krita Mahima, because of Svatejaha, Atma Purusham. Atma Purushena Svatejasa Krita Mahima. He has got a greatness because of his Tejas. I just read that shlokam in Atma Purusham is so important that without that Atma Purusham, Avikramam Vipadaha Ayanti. A lot of calamities come to a person who does not have that Atma Purusham. And a person Apadyuktam Purusham Ayatihi Nasti. He does not have a future. And a person who is nirayatehe, a person who does not have future, laguta niyata, he is treated as a very small person in the world. And agariyan nan ripashriya, a small person can never attain Rajalakshmi. The process he gives with Karanamala there, beautifully there, why Atma Purusham is very important. Atma Purusham, vinipata nivartana kshamam alambanam. It is an alambanam, it is a support for recovering ourselves from any sort of situation that we may fall into. So it is very important. So swatejah tejasa krita mahima yasya saha simha. So this is lion is an animal which is gay, which has become the king of the forest because of its tejaha. It has bought its position, its greatness because of that. How can it be compared with anybody else? It cannot be overcome. Atishayate. It cannot be overcome, overshadowed by anybody else. Who can overshadow it? Mahadbirapi matangaihi kim abhibhuyate. Another reading is kena abhibhuyate is also another reading that Diditikara gives. Where he says mahadbirapi matangaihi simhaha kena prakarena abhibhuyate athava kim abhibhuyate kim. Is a lion, can a lion be defeated by elephants just because they are big? Mahadbihi matangaihi, mahadbirapi matangaihi, even by huge elephants which are huge in size. But for valor we only look at the simha. Abhibhuyate kim, is he being defeated by the elephants even though the elephants are big? Now evamadishu slokeshu satsu api purvasmin shlokah yaha purvasmin shloke kim inadat arthantara sankramita. Yes, yav pratamaha pratamaha satu tathahi hatahasti bahala palala ashi palala palala ashi shvapada ganeshu simhaha simhaha kena adhari kriyate. This is similar to that shlokam we read before, kamalani kamalani. Yeah, I think the first two Udyotam we read that shloka. Kamalani Snigdha Shyamala Vitsalipliyataha Kapram Tada Jayante Gunani Yadate Sahrideyer Grihyante Ravikirana Anugrihitani Bhavanti Kamalani Kamalani. Only when those lotuses which have been touched upon by Ravikirana, Surya Kirana, only those lotuses are more beautiful. So Dvitiya Kamalasya Saurabham Saundaryam, everything. So in the same manner, we are going to look at this shloka also, where the second word, which is a repeat, has to have other meanings to it. Yav Pratamaha Sayeva Pratamaha Yav Pratamaha Sayeva Pratamaha. The one who is first is indeed first. What does that mean? Pradhanaha Sayeva Asadharanatvam Tatra Vingyam. Nobody can compare. Avanda Modanmayanavan. Avdingarcha and the Kakuli Namakandu Buriano. No, with that the swaram, the dhvani will just give you so much of idea in your mind. He is the first one. In fact, the first the one who comes first is indeed the first one. Saha Simhaha Statahi Hata Hasti Bahala Palala Ashi Palalam Ashnoti Iti Palala Ashi. So he the lion which eats the meat, palala palalam ashnoti, the one that palalam is meat, mamsam, mamsna mamsashi kutra asti mamsam hata hasti bahalam. He has killed, the lion kills the elephant by himself, and from that elephant he takes the flesh from the temple, or bahala, thick mamsa. Hata hastinaha bahala sthula mamsam ashnoti yaha simhaha sayeva simhaha kena adhari kriyate. That is a separate word. So shvapada ganeshu sayeva simhaha eva simhaha kimartham hata hasti pala abahala palalashi asti iti karanat shvapada ganeshu mrigeshu anya mrigeshu satsu simhaha eva simhaha iti ganyate. Nobody else can deny the fact that a simha is simha, because he shows his prowess by killing an elephant by himself. He will not touch anything, any other corpse of an animal. The simha targets its own corpse only when it is hungry and it eats the mamsam. So hata hasti, it kills on its own the elephant and eats the mamsam from that elephant that was killed by himself. So shvapada ganeshu, among other beasts, shvapada is any four-legged beast. So shvapada ganeshu, among beasts, simhaha eva simhaha. Only a lion is called a lion. So as a simhatvam iti dharmaha, tatra we think of immediately viratvam. He is indeed brave because he is capable of killing a big elephant. Madbirapi matangaihi simhaha kim abhibhuyate. Same idea only. But here, hata hasti bahala palala lashaha simhaha eva simhaha iti arthantare sankramitam dvitiya simha saptaha. Arthantare ityukte viratve vismayatve. Someone can be very surprised, because if you look at the ratio, an elephant is probably 6 times the height of a simha. There is no comparison between the size and the height of both animals. Yet this lion has its target as an elephant itself is a vismayakari. Viratvam vismayatvam cha dharmaha tad dharme sankrantam dvitiya simha shabdaha. इत्येवमादिषु श्लोकेषु सत्सु अपि अर्थान्तर संक्रमितवाच्यध्वनि समाश्रयेण नवत्वं सुप्रतिभानन्त्यम्. एनी श्लोक वी कैन टेक विच इज अ वेरी साधारण श्लोकम एंड वी कैन गिव इट अ ब्यूटिफुल कलर डिफरेंट डायमेंशन फॉर दैट. इदु वंदु वी विल टेक इट अप नेक्स्ट क्लास. स्टॉप विथ दिस.